The Middle East, a region where heat records are constantly being broken, rivers are drying up, and lakes are disappearing from the map. Once the cradle of civilization, these lands today are suffocating under the weight of a water crisis. In Iran, the president recently warned that if it doesn't rain soon, we may have to evacuate Tehran, marking one of the most alarming drought alerts in the nation's history. Reservoirs are nearly empty, and groundwater resources are collapsing. In Iraq, the waters of the Tigris and Euphrates don't even reach half of their former volume. Agriculture is dying out, and people in Basra are being forced to drink salty water. In Syria, after more than a decade of war, drought has deepened the food crisis even further. Fields that once produced crops now produce only dust storms. In Turkey, as groundwater recedes in the Konya Plain, giant sinkholes are opening up, and the country's two largest cities, Istanbul and Izmir, are getting closer to water scarcity every day. Jordan has become one of the world's poorest countries in terms of per capita water availability. And in Yemen, water is now more valuable than oil. Yet amid all this, there's one country in the region that seems almost immune to the crisis, as if it has access to an endless water source. It turns seawater into drinking water, recycles wastewater, and squeezes value out of every drop. While the water crisis is destroying agriculture across the Middle East, this country is farming right in the middle of the desert, so efficiently that it's now among the world's leaders in agricultural innovation. That country is Israel. About 80% of Israel's drinking water now comes from desalinated seawater from the Mediterranean. Most of the rest comes from recycled wastewater. Nearly 94% of all wastewater in the country is collected and treated, and 87% of agricultural water comes from this recycled supply, by far the highest rate in the world. As a result, Israel has become one of the rare desert nations that's fully self-sufficient in both drinking water and agriculture. But how did Israel make this happen? Half of Israel's territory has a semi-arid climate, and its south is dominated by a desert climate. Annual average rainfall is around approximately 800 millimeters in the north of the country, 400 millimeters in the eastern interior, and only 20 millimeters in the south. The country historically had to rely only on the Sea of Galilee in the north and limited groundwater. However, increasing population, intensive agricultural activities, and regional drought cycles brought freshwater sources to critical levels in the late 20th century. Thus, the desalination of seawater stopped being an environmental choice and became an absolute necessity for the nation's survival and national security. This necessity drove scientists and the government to search for ways to remove the salt from seawater. Israel's water desalination journey began in the 1960s with the chemist and inventor Alexander Zarkin, who laid the foundations for today's mega facilities. Zarkin patented a process based on the principle of freezing seawater for purification in 1964. In this method, seawater is frozen under vacuum, forming pure ice crystals. These are then melted to produce fresh water, while the salt is removed in the process. The technology wasn't very efficient, but it symbolized national determination. Zarkin later founded IDE Technologies in 1965, a company that would become one of the global leaders in desalination technology. When reverse osmosis technology emerged, everything changed. This process forces seawater through a semi-permeable membrane under high pressure. The membrane lets water molecules pass, but blocks salt and impurities. Israel was among the first to adopt large-scale reverse osmosis systems to fight water scarcity. The first seawater desalination plant opened in Eilat in 1997. Though small in scale, it became a symbol of hope for the nation's water future. In 2002, due to the effect of the drought, the government approved the construction of large seawater desalination plants along the Mediterranean coast. The goal was to desalinate 305 million cubic meters of seawater annually by 2010 and 500 million cubic meters annually by 2015. Capacity rapidly increased with the Ashkelon plant, which became operational in 2005, and the Hadera plant, which opened in 2009. By the end of 2008, a total capacity of 130 million cubic meters per year was activated. During this period, Israel not only built desalination plants, but also launched widespread water conservation campaigns. By 2012, the Ashkelon plant alone was producing 15,000 to 16,000 cubic meters of water per hour, covering around 15% of the nation's total demand. Then, in 2013, the Sorek plant opened, one of the largest reverse osmosis facilities in the world, capable of producing 234 million cubic meters of fresh water per year. Today, Israel converts roughly 2 million cubic meters of seawater into fresh water every day. Most of it goes to homes and cities, while the rest supports safe irrigation for agriculture. As a result of this transformation, the pressure on Israel's historical freshwater sources rapidly decreased. Lake water usage, which was 513 million cubic meters annually in 2001 to 2002, dropped to only 25 million cubic meters in 2018 to 2019. In short, while most natural freshwater sources were preserved despite rising population and agricultural demand, the new source of water in the taps became the desalination plants. Thus, Israel never faces a problem with drinking water, even during major drought periods. Additionally, with the reverse national water carrier system, which became operational in 2023, the excess desalinated water is pumped into the Sea of Galilee. This helps stabilize the lake's water level and turns it into a reliable backup reservoir. Of course, this water freedom also has a financial dimension. Ashkelon was reported to cost $250 million, Hadera $425 million, and Sorek $450 million. The cost of new facilities like Sorek 2 is estimated to be over $500 million. Then there is the issue of transporting the desalinated water. The purified water from some facilities is connected to the national transmission network and pumped into storage and distribution grids across the country. However, new pumping lines are also required. After 2009, new east-west main water lines were constructed to connect the coastal desalination plants with inland users. Government reports and Mekarot documents state that this program was built with an investment of approximately $500 million. Beyond construction costs, the production cost per cubic meter of desalinated water also matters. According to the Israel Water Authority, large-scale seawater reverse osmosis plants produce water at around 54 cents per cubic meter. That's more expensive than natural freshwater, which costs about 10 cents per cubic meter, but still considered highly efficient by global standards. In many countries, desalination costs range between 50 cents and $1 per cubic meter, and in some cases, exceed $3. But desalination is only half the story. Israel is also a world leader in wastewater recycling. According to the OECD, about 94% of wastewater in Israel is collected and treated, and over 87% of that is reused, mostly for agriculture. The Shafdan wastewater treatment plant near Tel Aviv processes about 370 million liters of sewage every day, sending it through underground pipelines to irrigate farms in the dry Negev desert. With new regulations that came into force in 2010, the salinity and heavy metal content of the wastewater to be used for irrigation were restricted. Thus, the quality control of the treated water was tightened, and the suitability of the recycled water for agriculture was monitored. The abundance of reclaimed and desalinated water has completely changed Israel's agriculture. The country meets a very large part of its food needs through local production and achieves high yields in fruit, vegetable, and grain farming, despite the desert climate. Since most irrigation uses treated wastewater, freshwater reserves are kept mainly for drinking purposes. This balance secures reliable water supply both in cities and in rural areas. Israel's experience demonstrates effective measures that can be taken against large-scale water crises. Converting large amounts of salt water into drinkable water by building mega facilities is a method that can set an example for other arid regions. In the end, the lesson is clear. In arid regions like the Middle East, the path to survival runs through innovation and investment. Water is no longer just a natural resource, it's a matter of national security. And Israel's desalination revolution shows that with technology, even the ocean can become a country's drinking water. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.